welcome to the 11th, hard to believe, 11th annual Meet the Candidates Night, sponsored by the Brookfield Republican Town Committee. My name is Stephen Cumtor, the chairman of that said Republican Town Committee. We do have one contested race, that's the Cemetery Commissioner's seat. It's a three-year term, unfortunately vacated by a very good friend of the town, Mr. O'Leary. To my left, we have William Pratt, and we have Robert Barnes. Thomas Morris is not here this evening. He will be the third individual on the ballot. And again, this is the only contested race. First and foremost, thank you candidates not only for coming tonight, but running for a pretty tough position, in my opinion. And thank you for everybody that came out, and thank you for watching us on TV. The election is May 1st. Is it from 7 to 7? 12 hours. Vote early and vote often. We're going to do this the same as we've always done. Opening statement. People in the crowd will ask questions. Closing statement. And we're done. Anything we'd like to say? No questions? All right. I'm going to start right to my immediate left, Mr. Pratt. Yeah. Opening statement. The floor is yours, sir.
Well, I've been in town since 1973. We bought our house up on Draper Street in 1981. I went to school at the University of Massachusetts for landscape design and construction. Spent 4.5 years in the Air Force active duty and 2 years in active. I worked for Kessler & Morse Company for 37 years, selling building supplies, brick, blocks, cements, everything all the way through suspended ceilings and tile. I've been on Conservation Commission years ago in town. I've worked on several projects in town, such as putting the retaining wall and patio around the gazebo and the stand underneath the statue at St. Mary's Church. And I think most of the people in town know me. I've been around for a long time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Barnes.
Yeah. I'm a third generation. I've been in Water Commissioner for going 17 years. I've been on advisory board for about 15 years. My last job was with the North Brookfield Highway and the U.S. Postal Service. I worked two jobs at one time. My thing to doing this is that I can help out down there quite a bit. I have a hydraulic license, which the tractor down there takes a hydraulic license to run. So I'm just offering my service. If whatever the people vote is what it's going to be.
Thank you, sir. Opening statements complete. Questions from the crowd. We only have two individuals running, so I'm going to allow both candidates to answer questions if they choose to. Maybe even a little back and forth. I don't think there's going to be much of that. But feel free. Obviously, I'm here to keep it civil and ask the crowd to do that as well. Anybody like to ask any questions? Nobody.
Is Cemetery Commissioner a paid position?
No.
It is not.
Anybody else?
And I can give this to both of the candidates. What of your past experience do you think is going to be most important in serving the town on Cemetery Commissioner?
I'll go first. I've had a lot of experience with work with masonry. I've done some work at St. John's Cemetery in Worcester repairing broken headstones. I have a pretty extensive background on different types of adhesives and how to repair headstones and stuff along that line, as well as cleaning with chemicals, different shirting products and stuff that I've sold and worked with for several years.
Thank you.
I've been a truck driver all my life. I have the equipment operator. I've built catch basins and stuff, so I kind of know what's got to be done, drainage and all that. So it's part of what's going on down there, I guess. So keeping the place looking nice is what the only complaints I hear. You know.
Anybody else? Yes, ma'am.
The Cemetery Commission has a budget which is submitted to the Advisory Committee. each year. Mr. Barnes, if you get this position, will you surrender your post on the advisory committee because of the conflict of interest?
On the advisory committee, if I was on that, I'd have to abstain from anything.
I see. And the follow-up to that is, if the cemetery commission does have a budget, if it turns out that because of the historical nature of the property and its value to the town, the cemetery commission does not have sufficient funds to do the work that it needs to do, I'd like to hear from both of you whether or not you would, what your options would be in that case as far as your budgeting goes.
Oh, I would think we'd be looking for grants, but I don't know.
I would also think we'd be looking for grants and possibly some donations from local companies to help out with repairs or whatever we need for materials.
Thank you, man. Anybody else? Last call. Yes, ma'am.
I'm under the presumption that both of you are farmers and that you're very well equipped with all kinds of hydraulic equipment, not just tractors, but...
Raised from a farm, ran a beef farm over in East Brookfield for years. Still have my own equipment that I'm working with as well, hydraulic equipment.
Do you want to comment? Well, I own and operate equipment every day, so it's, I think in either case, it's an advantage to the cemetery.
Anybody else? Yes, ma'am.
What, in your opinion, is the most valuable artifact in the cemetery?
The old headstones. Some of the old headstones need some repair and some cleaning still. We just had a couple of tree limbs come down and there are a couple of broken headstones down that should be repaired. And I think it's important to keep the old part of the cemetery looking as good as the new part all the time. And there's some tree removal work that definitely needs to be done down there.
Yeah, I agree. The whole kitchen needs to be looked at, what needs to be done down there.
Anybody else? Anybody wants to ask a question? Come on, over here. Nobody? Do you want to here?
It's your turn.
It's my turn. I want to ask questions. I do have a question. Expansion. Do you guys have any plans for expansion?
I don't know what's available personally for land that's abutting it. And that's something that has to be looked into in the future. We have to have some discussion with the other cemetery commissioners and some of the town leaders as to what is going to be required and whether they have for access to getting other property.
Well, they got rules and regulations about how long you've lived in town to be put in there and whether it's from the town. And they didn't want a fast growth down there from what I understand. You know.
So you're saying I couldn't be buried down there?
What?
You wouldn't want me buried down there?
I have a lot down there.
No, me myself.
Well, you don't have a lot now?
I don't want to buy a lot. That's pretty good.
You better buy it while they're cheap.
Well, it's cheap.
So, it'll all be new. There'll be a lot of lawn.
Yeah. Any other questions? Do you guys have any questions from each other?
Well, particularly, we've known each other for years.
Yeah. We never had a problem with each other, so I thought.
So I'm going to turn it back to closing statements. Mr. Bradley first, Mr. Barnes, closing statement.
Well, it's completely up to the voters who gets it. I mean, I think we both qualify and to do it. And
talk to them, my friend. The camera, that's who's watching it.
So, we'll know Monday who's going to be the new commissioner.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Brown.
I think I could offer some help to the town in several different ways on the cemetery commission. I'd like to get an opportunity to give my best at trying for it. And I appreciate anyone's vote that would like to vote for me. If I don't get it, I don't get it. That's just the name of the game when it comes to politics. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Again, thank you for everyone coming out, asking questions. Thank you for watching Brookfield Public Access. Thank you for coming out and taping this for our citizens. And thank you for running. Again, elections Monday, May 1st. Come on out and vote. Just because we only have one contested race doesn't mean you can't have your voice heard. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.